Hey everyone, this is Rachel, and welcome to another scrapbooking process video. If you hang out until after the video is through, there are always detailed shots of my current layout. Let's get going! Hey everyone, so I am working at a crop. This video was taped at a crop I went to back in March 2019, but it is a Christmas layout and it's probably going to go up sometime in May. Now you're going to hear some music underneath. I don't normally do this, but the subject of this layout happens to be my nephew's Christmas concert at a community band he belongs to that performs and is held through a local university, and so I thought I'd share one of the songs just playing quietly in the background. It's actually called Russian Christmas Music, and it was the one I could think of that wasn't actually had music rights to, because it's a lot of Nutcracker and stuff like that. It's not very Christmassy, it is very Russian, so I don't know, maybe you'll enjoy it, maybe it'll just be annoying in the background. I apologize if it is. Alright, I am working with Simple Stories. Oh sugar, I don't remember what this is called. They released it this year. I wasn't going to buy any Christmas, and then I saw this, and it's very small. It's one of their little simple sets, so it just has three pieces of paper, and they give you two sets of paper in the thing. So you get six pieces of paper and a 6x12 sticker sheet, and that's it. It was like $7, and I know I said I wasn't gonna buy any Christmas, but this one I really, really, really liked it. I tend to go towards a traditional for Christmas, and for some reason I've gotten in this cycle of picking up the Pink Fresh Studio, which is very non-traditional, so I needed a little bit more traditional Christmas, just a little bit, and I've actually already used it, you'll see here, and I think I used it in another video. I don't remember if it's this one or if it's another Christmas collection I own. Anyway, let's start talking about the layout. So as you can see, I've got two 3x4 photos. For those of you who have kids in band or sports or anything where they do the same thing year after year after year, and you're taking the same photos year after year, after a while, you're not getting the great photos. You know, my nephew's done two of these concerts a year since seventh grade. So you do the math, I'm not going to. And at this point, it's just like, okay, look, they're all standing up and facing front, let's take a couple pictures and we're good. But I did want to scrapbook this one because it is his last Christmas concert. They don't really do a lot of Christmas music, but they do a concert around Christmas time. So I decided, because the papers here are very dark and very rich, I did want a large white mat around both of my photos. I am then going to use a large chunk of this plaid paper, and I'm actually going to mat that as well with the leftovers of the white cardstock that I matted the photos on, simply to give your eyes a break from all that dark, dense color. I am going to, as I said, mat it on here, and then I'm going to use that green and red vine paper as my background. And I know it seems kind of, you know, it's like, well, if you feel it's so dark, why don't you just do it on white cardstock or a lighter cardstock? I just really liked the way this looked. I thought it added some gravitas. They tend to do incredibly difficult music for, these are juniors and seniors in high school, and for their age, they are working with incredibly intense music, and I just really felt it needed a somberness or a seriousness to the types of papers I was choosing. I know that sounds insane, but it makes sense in my brain, and that's what I try for when I'm doing my own scrapbooking. So I'm looking to see if I want to use any of these cut-aparts, and I decide rather than the cut-apart, I would use that sticker that says Joy for part of my title. Before I work on that, though, I am going to go ahead and get this piece down on the back paper. And I'm kind of looking, making sure I don't want to tuck anything behind. Now, because I'm at a crop, I do have a tendency to work a little bit slower because I'm listening to people talking and I'm maybe talking myself. Maybe. I am most likely talking myself. And so I'm just everything, I have to speed things up a little bit more than I usually would. And even then, I end up having to trim pieces out just because I'm randomly talking to someone or someone will come over and I'm explaining my page to them. I am going to be using, as I said, that joy sticker for part of my title. And then I'm using this, I want to say it's one of those like called thick and thin or this and that or something along those lines. I do believe it came out with an Amy Tangerine line, but I don't remember what it's called. I do want, like, it is something like thick and thin or this and that, something along those lines. And then I'm going to finish off my title with the Fitzgerald in Gold Glitter. And so my entire title is actually Joy in Music. And I thought that was a nice, joy as in like joy to the world, blah, 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 that type of thing. And then talking about how much fun he's had performing with this program for this many years. I'm not going to do a ton of journaling. As I said, for those of you who've done the 80 million soccer layouts or the 500th marching band layout, you do a lot of them throughout the years. I've done several of them. And so there isn't that much more to say other than this is, I believe my journaling consisted of, this is my nephew's final Christmas performance with Jiwi, and then I do like December 2018. I do add from the sticker sheet a couple of these poinsettias, and then I'm going to use several of the word and phrase stickers, and a lot of them are like music titles. And then I'm also bringing in, this is just some random clear stickers I have. I don't even know how I got them. Either they came in a kit at some point, or I picked them up like at a give and take table, and they just say Noel and peace, and then they have stars and stuff, and they're just a clear sticker with gold foil. And so I add a Noel in the upper left corner, and then I add a star in the middle over, or a couple of stars over by the word joy. I'm going to keep it very simple, embellishment-wise. I have a lot of pattern going on. I'm actually done embellishing. I know for those of you who've seen my layouts, for me, this is very minimal in the embellishment department, but sometimes you gotta keep it simple. I am going to be using one of these Ellie Studio labels to do my journaling. I first pulled out the ones over on the right there for to do it, but I realized that was way too much space for the two sentences I had to say about that. So I do find this other one in a green, and as I said, I'm just going to talk about the fact, I'm just going to say it was his last Christmas concert with this particular program. He is going to continue playing in college. He's not majoring in music or anything like that, but the college he goes to has a wind ensemble for non-music majors, so he was super excited to hear about that. It's like a one credit class and you can repeat it however long you want, but you only get credit for up to 3 credits or 4 credits, something like that. But it's fine. He enjoys it. It's 1 hour a week. So it's actually less time than he rehearses with this group. I'm rambling. I apologize. I should have cut a little bit more of this out than I did. I'm looking for my pen, actually. So it's absolutely riveting what's going on here. I can't believe I didn't cut this out. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna let you listen to the music while I write my journaling. And let me tell you, I have no idea why I didn't go ahead and glue this down before I started writing, rather than have to hold it there.
Thank you.
Right during the music portion where they did their kind of ending portion of that part of the song. The song actually goes on for like another 10 minutes, but I had to lop it off because my film only went this 12 minutes long, and it was like 22 minutes long. I hope you enjoyed that. Those low notes along with the bells, that's my nephew. Actually, he plays the baritone saxophone. All right, I did add some enamel dots. Those were from my mind's eye. And what I'm doing now is adding some Heidi Swap Gold Color Shine. In a second, I did have to borrow a rubber band. Little tip, if you can't open a screw top of a Heidi Swap Color Shine because it got smushy stuff around it, just wrap a rubber band around the screw top portion. And it works really well to get it open. All right, folks, that is going to be my layout for today. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you didn't mind the music. If you could flick me a thumbs up, that would be super awesome. And if you have any comments, just leave it in the description box below. There are photos coming up right now. Bye.